In this video, I'm going to show you how to remove unwanted elements from photos using the patch tool with Content Aware. Hey everyone, welcome to the Photoshop Training Channel. My name is Jesus Ramirez, and you can find me on Instagram at JR from PTC. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use the patch tool with Content Aware. With the Content Aware option, the patch tool becomes more powerful because it allows you to synthesize nearby content for seamless blending with the surrounding content. The results are very similar to using the Content Aware fill, but by using this tool, you have the option to choose the source area and also work non-destructively. I'm going to show you how this tool works in two examples. We're going to use a portrait to remove wrinkles, and we're going to use this photo of Venice to remove distracting elements. So let's start with the portrait first. I'm going to zoom in. And if we wanted to remove one of these wrinkles, for example, the one here on his forehead, we could of course make a selection and fill with Content Aware. So edit, fill, Content Aware, and it sort of removes the wrinkle. You can sort of see that the Content Aware sampled from this area here, bringing in another wrinkle. I'm going to press Ctrl-Alt-Z, Command-Option-Z on the Mac to undo. What we're going to do instead is select the Patch tool, which is nested under the Spot Healing Brush tool. Make sure that Content Aware is selected. And we can click and drag and decide what area to sample from. So the Content Aware fill automatically sampled from that area, which introduced that other wrinkle. We're going to just go up a bit higher and sample from this area so that no other wrinkles are introduced. I'm going to zoom in and you can see that it did a much better job. However, much like the Content Aware fill, we are working destructively and we don't want to do that. So I'm going to press Ctrl-Alt-Z, Command-Option-Z on the Mac to undo. I'm going to create a new layer. I'm going to make sure that sample all layers is selected, and I'm going to redo that last step. So I'm going to click and drag and sample from this area. The advantage of using the patch tool is that you also have access to the structure in color, so you can adjust how those pixels were generated. I'm going to press Ctrl-H, Command-H on the Mac to hide the selection. The selection is still there, it's just hidden. If I come under Structure and adjust the slider back to number 1, you'll see how those pixels change as I make those adjustments. Structure specifies how closely the patch should reflect existing image patterns. If you enter 7, the patch adheres very strongly to the existing image patterns. If you enter 1, the patch adheres very loosely to existing image patterns. And obviously there's different levels in between. You also have color. Color specifies the extent to which you want Photoshop to apply algorithmic color blending to the patch. 0 disables color blending, and a color value of 10 applies maximum color blending. So you can keep making adjustments to the sliders to change how the pixels blend, obviously making it more powerful than the simple Content Aware fill. Also, in a situation like this, when we're working with skin and we have skin texture, you'll notice the texture is brighter than the area that we brought in. By working non-destructively in a new layer, we can take advantage of blending modes. So we can select a blending mode such as lighter color, which always reveals the lightest color, either the layer that you're currently on or the layers below. If I select it, you'll see that we're going to bring back some of that texture. The only things that we're concealing are the darker areas that make up that wrinkle. So we can also adjust the opacity. I don't want to remove the wrinkle. I just want it to be less distracting. So I'm just going to bring down the opacity. So it's still there. It's just not as noticeable. I'm going to double click on the hand tool to fit the image to screen. That's the before and the after. Maybe I can increase the opacity even further. Maybe 75%. And that's the advantage of using the patch tool with Content Aware. You can, of course, zoom in and remove other distractions on the face. Maybe I can remove that blemish here by using the same technique. I'm going to press Ctrl-D, Command-D to deselect. In this case, I don't think I need to make any adjustments with blending modes or opacity, so I'll leave it as is. And you can keep making any other adjustments that you want. The patch tool is also really good at removing distracting elements from other kinds of photos, like this photo of Venice here. I'm going to zoom in to this area where these people are sitting, and I can make a selection with the patch tool. Then I can click and drag and sample from this area here. And that removes the people sitting in that area. I'm going to press Control D, Command D to deselect. I'm going to zoom out just so you can see what it looks like. Obviously, that was a destructive effect because I didn't create a new layer. So always remember to work non-destructively by creating a new layer and making sure that sample all layers is selected. So once again, I'll make that same adjustment. And you can press Control H, Command H on the Mac to hide the selection. And you can adjust the structure to change how the pixels blend. I'm going to press Control H, Command H on the Mac again to bring back the selection. So you can see the selection is still there. And I can press Control D, Command D to deselect. At this point, you can refine some of the shadows that we brought in. I'm not going to do it in this video just for the sake of time, but whenever you make an adjustment like this, you sometimes may need to refine the pixels that were generated. Also, I want to point out that this video is one of the videos in my Content Aware series. If you haven't watched the other Content Aware videos, check out that playlist on my YouTube channel. There is a link for it right below in the description of this video. And that's it for this tutorial. Let me know in the comments down below if you knew about this tool and how it works. Also, let me know if you have any comments or questions. If this is your first time at the Photoshop Training Channel, don't forget to click on that subscribe button. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.